process is the legal requirement that a government must respect a person's legal rights before taking from them life, liberty, or property. Elements of due process include the right to a notice of the charges against you, the opportunity to be heard, and the opportunity to defend yourself. When a system of law ignores these steps before convicting a person, this constitutes a violation of due process and the rule of law. Both the 5th and 14th Amendment to the Constitution guarantees that no person shall be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law. The origin of due process of law traces back to King John's Magna Carta, which provides that no man will be seized, dispossessed of his property, or harmed except by the law of the land, a phrase that referred to customary practices of the court.
The Loving v. Virginia case of 1963 was a prime example of the violation of equal protection and due process clause of the 14th Amendment. This case follows a couple, Richard and Mildred Loving, who got married in Washington, D.C. on June 1958, where interracial marriage was legal. However, once they returned to their hometown in Virginia, they were charged with violating Virginia's law, deeming interracial marriage a felony. The couple then tried to appeal for the case 5 years later. Here is an interview following the Lovings and their journey.
What happened after the arrest?
We were sentenced to 1 year in prison unless we moved to Washington, D.C. And so we did. After a couple of years, we fought for this case.
So how far did this case go?
Our case made it to the Supreme Court, where it was then ruled that Virginia's miscegenation law was illegal under the 14th Amendment, which guarantees all citizens due process and equal protection under the law.
Hello, I am Ashley Stewart at the San Diego County Law Firm, and I have been helping and defending people like you for 25 years. People who need legal defense in robbery and felonies like fraud and assault and battery, as well as misdemeanors like DUIs. You reserve many rights as citizens, one being the right to due process of law. Being that I specialize in this field, I am a perfect candidate to defend people like you in trial. If you feel as though you are in need of legal assistance, call my number at 888-555-LAWYER-ME-NOW.
The 1993 case of Akron versus Akron Center of Reproductive Health was a prime example of how the Akron Ordinance violated women's reproductive rights as well as the right to privacy doctrine stated in the 14th Amendment. The decision to protect the rights that should be reserved by women was made by the court when the court invalidated the provisions and circumstances of the ordinance. This case is related to and reiterated the Roe versus Wade case in that certain provisions of the ordinance violate the Constitution, being that they intend to direct women away from choosing abortion.
Under Chicago Gang Congregation Ordinance, criminal street gang members are prohibited from loitering with one another or with other persons in any public place. This law violates the Due Process Clause of the 14th Amendment of the United States Constitution if it's so vague and standardless that it leaves the public uncertain as to the conduct it prohibits.
Can you tell me about the incident?
My friend and I were harassed outside 7-Eleven by a police officer who thought we were doing a suspicious activity.
Why do you think the police officer stopped you?
We weren't doing anything wrong, just minding our business.
Hey, what are you guys doing here?
Nothing, officer. We're just hanging out.
Well, you look very suspicious. You need to leave.
You can't just accuse us of anything. We weren't doing anything wrong.
Well, you guys are loitering up against the wall.
What? What are you doing?
This.
Is this allowed?
Have you ever faced corruption by a police officer? Well, we have just the product for you. This is called the Protect You Body Camera. By wearing this, you will always be protected no matter what. Call now at 1-800-PROTECT-YOU for only $250.99. Batteries not included.
Must be 18 or older to order. Does not include a safety pin or camera. Additional tax may apply. So call now at 1-800-PROTECT-YOU to get a reduced price of $399.
During Tommy Granville and Brad Troxell's relationship, which ended in 1991, they had two daughters, until Brad's suicide in 1993. Brad's parents, Jennifer and Gray Troxell, the paternal grandparents, had regularly seen their granddaughters on weekends. However, after Brad's suicide, Granville informed the Troxells that she wished to reduce their visitation time to one short visit per month. The Troxells filed for suit for the right to visit their grandchildren under Section 3 of the Revised Code of Washington, which permits any person may petition the court for visitation rights at any time, including but not limited to custody proceedings. The court may order visitation rights for any person when visitation may serve the best interests of the child, whether or not there have been any changes in circumstances.
So what brought you guys to court?
After our son died, all we wanted was to be able to see our grandchildren anytime we had the chance to. However, Miss Granville is not allowing us to.
What did you guys try to do after?
We begged for at least 2 weeks of overnight visitation per month and 2 weeks of visitation during the summer, but Miss Granville only wants to see our grandchildren once per month with no overnight stays at all.
Based on the argument presented by the two groups today, I have decided for the Troxells to have 1 weekend visitation per month, 1 week during summer, and 4 hours on each of the grandparents' birthdays.
Substantive due process is a legal theory outlining restrictions on the government's ability to infringe upon constitutional liberties. Examples of substantive rights in the U.S. Constitution include the rights to freedom of expression and freedom of association. Critics of substantive due process argue that it upsets the balance of power between the branches of the U.S. government, giving undue power to the courts. They believe that the Supreme Court is given too much power over state law.
If we did not have a guarantee of due process of the Constitution, the rights that are specified in the Bill of Rights and elsewhere would be fairly meaningless. Without due process, it would be too easy for the government to take away our rights, even though those rights are specifically guaranteed by the Constitution. Thus, the guarantee of due process is a very important factor in ensuring that we actually have individual rights that are promised to us.